Hello everyone, once again I am here with you with a new chapter, and the chapter is the properties of water. Okay, in this I will explain you about the soluble substances, insoluble substances, solvent, solute and solution. Okay, so okay, now see this, in the two glasses water is there. And see this tray. In this tray, I am having different substances. One is the one is the salt, and the this is sugar, tea leaves, quince. This is lemon, and in this lemon, lemon juice is there. Now I am going to. See this. First of all, I am going to tell you one thing, that see the water is there in the glass, and that water is the solvent. Okay, this is the medium in which I will dissolve sugar, salt. Okay, so this water is the medium. Now I am going to dissolve this salt in water. See this, I pour the salt. And when you will stir well, then what will you see? It will dissolve completely in the water. Okay, see this. This salt is completely soluble in water. That means this salt is soluble in water. Soluble substance. Okay. Now I am going to take the sugar. And again I am going to put in the glass. I have water, and then you will see, what will you see? It will also dissolve completely in the water. You will see that salt and sugar, these are soluble in water. Here water is the solvent, that means this is the medium in which we dissolve salt and sugar, and salt and sugar are the solute. Okay, and when we dissolve salt and sugar in the glass of water, then we will get a solution. Okay, now I am going to mix lemon juice in the water. See this, and mix well. Then you will say, they will see that sugar, salt and lemon juice all are soluble in water. And do you know what we get when we dissolve sugar, salt and lemon juice in water? Then we will get nimbu pani. And this nimbu pani is very tasty, very yummy. So I have explained you about the soluble substances, and they are the sugar, salt and lemon juice. Sugar is the solid, and salt is solid, but lemon juice is the liquid, but it is soluble in water. Now come to the insoluble substances. See, I have taken tea leaves, and now I am putting these tea leaves in the glass of water. Now see what will happen. See this, it will float in water. Some leaves are floating on the water and some are sinking in the water. See this, see this. So you will see this here, tea leaves are insoluble in water. They are not getting dissolved in this water. Okay, now I am going to show you another experiment. Okay, now watch. See, the quince are there, and I am going to put these quince in the glass of water. Now see, what will you see? See, it will sink in water. You will see that quince will sink in water, and when you will try to dissolve it, it will not dissolve. Okay, so quince is insoluble in water. So I think it is clear to all of you that which are soluble, which are insoluble, what is solvent, what is solute and what is solution. These things today I have explained you, and the examples of the soluble substances and insoluble substances I have shown you. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.